Now I am going to discuss this sample problem 3-5, and it is from the topic of equilibrium in three dimensions, right? So in this problem, in this sample problem, it is said that we have a uniform 7 meter steel shaft and it has a mass of 200 kg, right? So that uniform 7 meter steel shaft has a mass of 200 kg and is supported by a ball and socket joint at A in the horizontal floor, right? So here we have a ball and socket joint, right? So this ball and socket joint can support the reactions in all three dimensions, in all three directions, right? And the ball end B rests against the smooth vertical walls as shown. So this is the ball and it rests against this walls, right? And it is said that compute the force is exerted by the walls and the floor on the end of the shaft, right? So we are asked to find the reactions at both the ends. So now if we draw the reactions, so then at this point A, since this is a ball and socket joint, so it can support the reactions in all three dimensions, in all three, along all three axes. And similarly, as we can see that these two walls will provide the reaction forces in the opposite direction, right? So these are those two reactions, and the weight of this shaft will act at the midpoint of this length, that is 3.5 distance from both end A and B, right? So this is the location of that weight, and the weight of this shaft is 200 times 9.81 newtons, right? So this is the weight. So first I will apply the summation of moment at A equals to 0. I will apply this equilibrium condition to find the reactions at point B, and we will use the vector approach, right? So first we will write that using vector approach, that is the cross product method, that is R cross F method. So we will use this method, right? So for that, first we will find the coordinates of point A, B and this point G, right? So what are the coordinates of point B if we want to write that coordinates, right? So the coordinates of point B are, so if, as we can see that this point B is in, is on the z axis, right? So this means that the x coordinate, the y coordinate are 0, and we have to travel this h distance, right? So here this distance is h, right? And we can determine this h as well. So first let me find this h distance, the height of this point B from this point, right? So how to find that distance? We are given the 7 meter, the 6 meter and 2 meter, right? To find this height, we can use the Pythagoras theorem. So if let's say that this is height, right? So this h, so this means that 7 square will be equal to 2 square plus 6 square plus h square by using the Pythagoras theorem, right? So h square will be equal to 7 square minus 2 square minus 6 square. And if we take the square root, so then we will get the h magnitude. So h comes out to be 3 meters, right? So this height is 3 meters, remember. So now we can write the coordinates of point B. So this is 0, 0 and 3. Now to find the coordinates of A, if this is the origin, right? So we have to travel this much distance along x. So this much distance is 2. So the coordinates of point A, let me write it here. So the coordinates of point A are, let me write it here, right? So the coordinates of A is 2. Along y we have to travel 6 meters, right? So this will be 6. And since this point A is in the xy plane, so there is no need to travel along z, right? So this is 0. And these coordinates are in meters. Let me write the coordinates of B here as well, right? So this will be 0, 0 and 3. And similarly, we have to write the coordinates of this point G, right? So let me draw some lines so that you people can imagine that lines, right? So let's say that this is the distance traveled along x, and then we have to travel this much distance along y, and then we have to travel this much distance along z, right? Since this is the midpoint of this AB, this length, right? So then this will be half of this 2 meters, right? So we have to travel this as 1 meter, and then this will be 3 meters, right? So if we write the coordinates of point G, so then we have to travel 1 meter along x, 3 meters along y, and this much distance, and it will be the half of this h, right? So this will be 3 divided by 2, so this will be 1.5 along z. So these are the coordinates of point G. So now if we apply this condition, that is the summation of moment along A, so then we will write that, and let's consider the reaction vector at this point B, right? So these are the coordinates of the reaction at B. So if we represent that as a vector B, if I write that B as a vector, and if Bx and By are the components of this B vector, so then we can write that Bx is along positive I and plus Byj, right? So this is that B reaction vector at point B. And similarly, if we write this G, this weight vector, right? So let's say that weight vector is W vector, let's say. So its magnitude is Mg, which is 200 into 9.81. Let me write mg, right? So we will write mg, and since this weight is acting vertically downward, so it is in the negative z direction, so we will write minus k. So this is that weight vector. So now to find this condition, that is the summation of moment about A equals to 0, let me write it here. So the summation of moment about A equal to 0. So we will take the cross product, so that will be the moment arm for this reaction at B will be this length, AB length, since the point of rotation is point A, right? So we will write that RAB, this is the moment arm for B vector, cross that B vector, plus the moment arm for G is RAG, right? So we will write RAG cross weight vector, right? So let me write that this is weight vector, and this will be equal to 0. So now to apply this equation, we have to find this RAB and RAG vectors, right? We know these B vectors and W vector. So to find RAB vector, let me write RAB vector. So we have to subtract the coordinates of A from B, right? So we will write that this will be, these are the A and B coordinates. So we have to write 0 minus 2i plus 0 minus 6j and plus 3 minus 0k. So this will give us minus 2i minus 6j and plus 3k. So this is the RAB moment arm vector. So this is the moment arm for that reaction at point B, right? So now we know this. Similarly, we can write RAG. So we will subtract the coordinates of A from G, right? So I will write this is 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2i plus 3 minus 6j plus 1.5 minus 0k. So the moment arm RAG equals to, so this will be minus 1i minus 3j and plus 1.5k, right? So now we can apply this equation, right? So R cross B. So if you want to find R cross B, we will write it like this. So this is I, J and K. So R vector, this is R A B vector. So we will write minus 2 minus 6 and plus 3 and b vector, right? So b is bx and by, and this is 0, right? And we will write plus I, j and k. Similarly, this is our ag vector. So this is our ag vector. We will write minus 1, minus 3 and 1.5. And w vector, so this is minus mgk, right? So this is 0, 0, and this is minus mg. Now, if we find the weight, so the weight comes out to be 1962 newtons, right? So if we multiply this, so we will get this 1962 newtons, right? So we will hide this and this row and this column, right? So we will take the determinant of this. So the determinant of this will minus 6 into 0. So this becomes 0 and this is minus 3 by, right? So I will write minus 3 by. Then we will hide this column and we will take the determinant of this. With j, we will write minus as well, right? So minus, this is again 0 and this is minus 3 bx. And this we have to write I with this as well, right? So this is I and this is j. And now we will hide this column. So we will take the determinant of this. So we will write plus, and this is minus 2 by minus 6 bx, right? So this is this first determinant, right? And this is R cross B, right? So this is R A B cross B. So we have found that cross product, right? So now we will write plus, and now we will hide this and this. So we will take the determinant of this, and this is 1962 minus 1962, right? So we will take the determinant of this. So this will be minus into minus plus 3 into 1962. And this will become 0, right? And we will write I with it. Similarly, we will hide this and we will take determinant of this, and with j we will write minus, and this is plus 1962 and this will become 0, right? So this is only 1962 minus, right? And then we will hide this. And we will take determinant of this, right? And this is j, right? Remember, this is j. And now we will take determinant of this, right? So plus, and this is 0 and 0, right? So this becomes 0. So this is the cross product. This is the second moment. This is the moment of w, right? So this is the moment due to the weight of that shaft, right? And this will be equal to 0. So now if we add up all the similar components, right? So this is the I component, right? So this is the I component. So I will write minus 3 by, and this is the I component, right? And this, that is plus. So you will write plus 3 into 1962. And these are along I, right? This is along K, right? So we have to write K here as well. So we have to add the j components, right? So this is the j component. So we can write plus, this is minus minus plus 3bx. And similarly this one, right? So this is minus 1962 and this is along j, right? And similarly this is along k, right? So we will write plus minus 2by, right? Let me write that this is by minus 6bx, and this is along k, and this is equal to 0, right? So now we have three equations, right, and two unknowns. So if we write this equation, so if we compare both sides of the equation, right, so there, here we have 0i plus 0j plus 0k, right? This will be 0 vector, right? So we can compare, right? So this will be equal to 0, so we can write that minus 3by plus 3 into 1962 equals to 0. So this means that by is equal to, this is minus 3 and this is minus 3, right? So this is 3 1962 minus and divided by minus 3. So this means that By is 1962 newtons, right? Similarly, we can write this as well. So 3 BX minus 1962 equals to 0. So BX is equal to 1962 divided by 3 newtons, right? And this third equation, if we write, so this is minus 2 BY minus 6 BX equals to 0, right? So this equation can confirm these both of these results, right? So if we put both of these values in this, so they will have to be equal to 0. The sum of both these terms, if we put the BY and BX in this equation, this third equation, right? So if the magnitudes of both of these are calculated accurate, so then we have to get 0 from this equation, right? So in this way we will find BX and BY, right? So now we have the magnitude of BX, the reaction at B along X, and the reaction at B along Y. So now we have those two reactions. Now to find the reactions at A, we can apply the summation of forces along X equals to 0. Summation of forces along X equal to 0, this is the equilibrium condition, right? So now as we can see that this BX is in the positive X direction, so I can write BX, and we know the magnitude of BX, right? So first let me find this magnitude. So BX is 1962 divided by 3, so this is 654, right? So this is 654 newtons, right? So BX is in the positive X direction, so I will write plus 654, and similarly this AX is in the negative X direction, so I will write minus AX. And since there are no other component in along the X direction, so we will equate it to 0. So this means that AX is 654 newtons. So now we know this AX. Similarly, if we apply the summation of forces along Y equals to 0, so now as we can see that this BY is in the positive Y direction, so that magnitude is 1962, so I will write plus 1962, and this AY is in the negative Y direction, right? So we will write minus AY. And there are no other component along Y, right? So we will equate it to 0. So this means that AY is equal to 1962 newtons. And similarly, we can find the AZ component as well. If we apply this condition, the summation of forces along Z equals to 0. So now as we can see that this AZ is in the positive Z direction, so we will write plus AZ. And this weight is in the negative Z direction, and its magnitude is 1962, right? So we will write minus 1962. So this is equal to 0. So this means that AZ is equal to 1962 newtons, right? So now we know this and we know this. And now if we want to find the resultant of both the reactions, right? So if we want to find the resultant reaction at this point B, so then B magnitude will be, the resultant magnitude will be BX square plus BY square under the root 2, right? So now we know these two magnitudes, so we can find that resultant as well. And similarly, we can find the A magnitude as well. So it will be AX square plus AY square plus AZ square, so we can find it. So you people can find it yourself as well, right? So this is one method. This was the cross product method approach, that is the vector approach, right? So we can find the solution of this problem by using the inspection method as well. So now we will apply the inspection method, that is also called as a scalar method, right? So let me write. So this will be by using inspection method that we have learned in the previous chapter, right? So inspection method. So now what I will do is that I will draw three axes at this point A, and let's say that this is the line parallel to z-axis is right. So if I move this line and I place this line here, and similarly if I draw a line parallel to x-axis is as well. So let's say that this is the positive x-axis is here, and now if I draw a line parallel to the y-axis is, so let's say that this is y-axis is. So now what we will do is that we will find the summation of moment at A along x equals to 0. So the summation of moment at A along x, so this is our x direction, this is our y, and this is z. So now if we observe these forces from this direction, right, so if we observe these forces from this direction, and as we can see that this AX, this AY, and this AZ, they are intersecting all the three axes, so they will never produce the moment about these three axes, these three green axes, right? So we will only deal with these three vectors, right? So now as we can see that this BX is parallel to the X axis, so it will not produce the moment about this X axis, right? So only these two forces are left, right? So first if we observe this weight, so this weight will produce the moment about x-axis in this direction, and if we curl our right hand fingers, so the direction is in the positive x direction, right? So this is our thumb direction. So if I write, so this will be plus, and weight is 1962, and the perpendicular distance of this weight from this x-axis is the half of this 6 meters, right? So this is multiplied by 3. So, and if we can see that this By is producing the moment about x, and the direction of that moment about x is like this, right? And if we curl our right hand fingers in this direction, so the thumb will point out in the negative x direction, so we will write minus, and that is By, and the perpendicular distance of this By from this x-axis is this h height, right? So this h height is 3, so this is equal to 0, and this is that same equation that we got from the cross product method, right? So this means that By is equal to again 1962 newton, right? So this is that same magnitude that we got by the previous method, right? So this is 1962. Now if we find the summation of moment at A along y equals to 0. So now if we observe these forces from this direction, right, from this direction, so this By will not produce any moment about y since it is parallel to the y axis, right? So only this weight and this Px are producing the moment about y. So if we observe this weight from this direction, so this weight is producing the moment about y axis is in this direction, right? And if we curl our right hand fingers in this direction, so the thumb will point out in the negative y direction. So I will write that minus weight is 1962, and the perpendicular distance of this weight from this y axis is this distance, right? So this is along the x axis. So keep in mind that if we are observing the forces from the y direction, and if the force is in the along the z direction, so the perpendicular distance will be along the x, right? So we are observing along y, the force is along z, so the perpendicular distance will be along the third axis, that is the x axis, right? So this is the distance, the perpendicular distance, and this will be half of this, right, since it is the midpoint. So this is 1 meter, right? So we will multiply this with 1. And similarly, this Bx. So now as we can see that this Bx is parallel to the x-axis, right? So we will write Bx. And since we are observing this force from the y direction, so the perpendicular distance of this Bx will be along z, right? So this is along z distance, and this is 3, right? So I will multiply this with 3, and this Bx is producing the moment about this y axis is in this direction, right? So this is trying to rotate this in like this. So if we curl our right hand finger, so our thumb will point out in the positive y direction, right? So I will write plus, and this is equal to 0. So this means that bx is 1962 divided by 3, which is again the same answer which we got from the previous method, that is 654 newtons. So now we know bx and by, and now we can apply these equations, summation of fx, summation of forces along y, and summation of forces along z. So this is the solution of this simple problem.